And we also included this chapter. It's also, I think, more for the Western eye or Western interest, because it's not so much about calligraphy, but it's about what is happening on the apartheid wall in Gaza and the West Bank, especially, and because there's a big movement of Western artists, street artists, who come there and paint the wall. And this is a chapter about this and the situation there also, because it's raising a lot of awareness, this painting on the wall. So we included this chapter also. This part is like about stances and graffiti in Beirut, which is linked to the civil war. They had like, it's also like similar to gang wars. I mean, they had a real war, not a gang war, but they were marking the territories with graffiti. So this is like the actual street art happening in Beirut. It's really nice because like I showed this a lot of time in Germany and I always had to translate it, and here you can just read it and have fun about it because it's really fun. Okay. So they have a big graffiti scene using Arabic script, and it's also different from what is happening in Europe because they write their names too, but a lot of times it has what they write is more about the message and the meanings of the writings and the words. So for this part also Pascal, he translated the things to me and found all the really important stuff from Beirut. And these are like, yeah, it reminds me also what I see now here in Cairo and Alexandria, street art examples. Yeah, it's all about taking back the public space, and that's also like a definition of graffiti, that you just take your space, you don't ask for permission, you paint, and especially try to make this public space more beautiful. This is one artist who always used the word Beirut in his graffiti, and he got very famous in Beirut. And yeah, his graffiti appeared on a lot of things like handbags and newspapers, on tattoos. Okay, so these were like examples of actual public art in the Middle East. If we do a second part, for sure there will be a chapter about Cairo, because the 2 days I was here, I saw so much and did so many photos. I think it's quite beautiful what is happening there right now. So these are artists who already took the step and come from traditional graffiti and used the Arabic script to evolve their own graffiti. Most of them have all of them have a background from the Middle East and North Africa. This guy El Sid, he is from Tunisia and he lives now in Canada. So he does also canvases. We had an exhibition with him in Berlin. Beautiful murals all over. He's traveling a lot and also will paint a big mural in Tunisia in November. This is Hest One. He lives in Jakarta. And Julien Breton, he is French, but he learned calligraphy. He's very much influenced by Hassan Masoudi, but he's also like coming from graffiti and hip-hop. So he mixes both arts and does light graffiti, like painting with light and making performances. And also like 3D sculptures, which are graffiti style but in Arabic. This is Laplace, he's also French, he learned calligraphy in Syria. And he's quite successful also in the art world. It's in Malaysia. This is the only guy we had who is like representing the Persian script, the Arabic Persian script. He's born in Iran and lives in Cologne, and he grew up like really the typical graffiti writer with hip hop music and painting trains with English words. And then he later he learned calligraphy in school, and later he made the link and is working now with the Arabic script. And these are the two artists from the beginning, Native and Santu. They're called a collective. One is from Nigeria, the other is born in France and grew up in the Middle East. This is Sunset, aka Jonas Bonnard, and he works with Latin letters but with arabesque styles. He's also working with Laplace together. Sadhu, he's tattooist and calligrapher. He uses both scripts, Arabic script in Latin and Latin in Arabesque. This is Sefa, Vincent Abadinefes. He also mixes the Latin script, the Arabic script. This is another collective, Light Breath. It's for artists like who work with music and light and photography. And they work together with different calligraphers and graffiti writers who use the Arabic script for their light graffiti. This is a collective, Lusar. It's two German artists and one Syrian, one Jordanian. They were based in Jordan, in Amman. And one of the artists is actually also here in Egypt right now, in Alexandria painting. And he will also be tomorrow in Townhouse Gallery. This is Ali, Aerosol Arabic, he's one of the very first graffiti writers who ever used the Arabic script in a graffiti style. And this is the last part of the book where we wanted to show the influence of design, of graffiti in design and vice versa. Like, because there's a lot of urban influences today in design, and I think also Mohammed can tell us something about it when we come to the logo section. Some work by Pascal Zonsky. He's also Louis Anwar, famous typographer also, the Lusar Collective again. Different examples from Morocco and Turkey and Lebanon. So there are a lot of logos also from Mohammed. Maybe you can say something about the influence of urban art and design.
Some problem. فالاول هي كانت فكره جميله جدا اني اشارك في كتاب زي كده، يعني الحمد لله بفضل من ربنا يعني انا بحب الكاليجرافي بشكل كبير جدا يعني، والحمد لله يعني قطعت فيه شغل كويس بفضل من ربنا سبحانه وتعالى. فكانت فرصه جميله جدا لما جون اتصل بيا وبعت لي ايميل وقال لي انا عايز مجموعه من الشغل بتاعك احطهم في الكتاب، واداني ديتيلد بريف بصراحه يعني كان بريف رائع يعني، اللي هو قال لي كل حاجه عن الكتاب من قبل ما اشوف الكتاب اصلا. فكانت فرصه لطيفه ان انا ابعت له مجموعه من شغلي، والحمد لله يعني قدر يعرض بعض منها لانها شويه متخصص اكتر في فن اللغة بالخط العربي. يعني دي المجموعه اللي نزلت الصفحه دي، وفي حاجات ثانيه بس احنا بنعرض بس ايه حاجات من الكتاب مش الكتاب كله. بس كنت عايز اقول يعني ان هي فرصه كويسه جدا ومشرف ليا ان اواخد او ان انا احط شغل ليا وسط العمالقه اللي موجودين في الكتاب، لان فعلا الفتره الاخيره من الناس ما تعرفوش بالذات في العالم العربي كله ان الخط العربي بقى محبوب جدا، وبالذات بره يعني للاسف احنا لسه ما اديناهوش حقه، مع ان بدا في ناس تاخد بالها من ان الحرف العربي شكله حلو. يمكن احنا كتير اكيد مننا شايف ان البراند نيمز اغلبها اللي موجوده احنا بقينا بنحبها بالحرف اللاتيني، مع ان في بعض الاحيان لما احنا عملناها لما بدانا ناخد السكه ان احنا نعملها بحرف عربي عجبت ناس كتير جدا، يعني كتير من البنات والسيدات الموجودين عارفين مثلا خلخال، الخلخال محل خلخال بتاع الاحذيه ده واحد برضه من اعمالي، فلما جينا كتبناها بالانجلش ما عجبتش الناس، لما اديناها ستايل عربي عجبت الناس ولقيت استحسان والحمد لله، يعني ناس كتيره جدا حابه الطريقه دي. فهي الفكره ان احنا يعني مش مديين الحرف العربي حقه، غير ان احنا كل فكرنا عن الحرف العربي اللي ما يقدرش يدي غير القوالب اللي محفوظه، سواء كان خط فارسي او ديواني او سورس او من القوالب القديمه المعروفه عند الناس اللي في بعض الاحيان بتبقى صعبه تحلم بها.
This is Khalid Said, and it's painted in Berlin on the Berlin Wall, on a piece of the Berlin Wall. I think a lot of people have seen it already here in Egypt. It happened like 3 weeks ago. It was a project also organized by me, and the artist who painted it, he is also in Alexandria right now, and he will be tomorrow with us in Taunus Gallery at 7 o'clock, and we will talk more about this, about their work. We also show a movie about graffiti and also present the book again. So if you want to come, you are very much welcome.
What's his name?
The name of the... Case, his artist name is Case.
He's not Egyptian?
Pardon me?
He's not Egyptian?
No, he's not Egyptian. The story is like Sahar Qasem, the sister of Khalid Said. She came to Berlin to receive in his name the Human Rights Awards from the Friedrich Ebert Stiftung in Berlin. It's a very huge, important foundation in Germany, and it was a great event. And just before, like 3 days or 4 days before the event, I got an email from a friend of her that she's looking for a wall in Berlin to paint a stencil of his face, because you have seen this face, of course, in Cairo, so she wanted to paint a stencil. Yeah, and I thought, okay, maybe it's better to paint the Berlin Wall with his face and his portrait. So it happened in 3 days that we organized the whole thing. The Berlin Wall, it was a real piece of it, so every part of it is two parts. It weighs like 3.8 tons. So we had to transport it there, and because of Khalid's name, he's so famous also in Germany, and of course everybody followed what happened here. It was just happening like by itself. Usually you can do something like this in 3 days, but it was really happening like there was a little magic of him, was it too? Also because the artist was just in Berlin by coincidence, and he's now here in Egypt too. And he will repeat this portrait also in Cairo.
It's a temporary or permanent artwork?
This is a permanent artwork.
Where is it then?
It's now at the foundation, and it will maybe stay at the foundation or go to the Freedom Park, which is on the Spree in Berlin. And yeah, it's a monument, so it will stay for a while, for sure.